What is happening, fellas? Today I'm coming to you from the cockpit. That's the only word to describe this thing. Interior. The cockpit of a 1994 NA Supra. And this isn't just any Supra, this is actually my own. So you guys know I'm coming, you know, I'm talking my own experience. I've actually owned this car for 4 years now, and it's been a mixed bag so far. I've had a couple of reliability issues, but they weren't really reliability issues. They were like, I think a couple of sensors went off, but they're more like maintenance issues. But overall, it's been a very smooth, no, I wouldn't say smooth, but very entertaining ride so far. For those that are interested in buying one of these, I think 2017 is a really great time to buy one, because the twin turbos are already well over $80,000, especially in America, right? So in decent condition. It's only a matter of time before one of these start going up in value. You know, people are going to realize that the twin turbos are expensive. These can be modified, which I'll get to later on. These can be modified, and you know, they're so cheap. They're like 5-10 grand, and it looks like a Supra. People are gonna buy these up, and when they do, these are gonna climb up in value very quickly. For those that are actually interested in buying one of these, or actually considering one of these, I think the most important thing you guys need to do is to kind of approach these cars from a different light compared to the twin turbos. These are very different cars compared to the twin turbos. I'm just gonna have to get that out of the way first. Yes, they look the same. Yes, they have very similar engines, apart from the turbos. But apart from that, they're very similar. The engines are, even though they're basically the same engine, but with turbos added on, these make like nearly like a quarter of the torque and a quarter of the power. Like, these are so much lower than the twin turbos. If you approach these cars from the same viewpoint as the twin turbos, you are gonna get disappointed. You're gonna feel, you know, it's not as like awe-inspiring as the twin turbo. These don't have that amazing, you know, turbo kick. These don't burn tires, unless you modify it, which this is more than capable of being modified to make 400-500 horsepower. But if you're just considering it in its stock form, don't expect magical power and the Supra straight line, Fast and the Furious. You're not going to get any of that with these, especially in NA form. So please keep that in mind. And with that being said, after you do accept all of those things, I think this is a very, very fun and entertaining car to own. Once you understand its limitations and what it can and can't do, it's actually a super fun car to live with. It's super cheap on the fuel, especially compared to the twin turbo. It's front engine, rear wheel drive, right? And it looks as good as this does. You really can't go wrong for less than 10 grand. You really can't. What other car even comes close to looking as good as this does, being front engine rear wheel drive and having like the Supra heritage? What other car has it? Like, I can't name five. Maybe the S13 Silvia's come close, but apart from that, what else? There's nothing, right? So in terms of the engine, this comes with a 225 horsepower NA 2JZ GE motor. At least it made 225 horsepower when it was new. I don't know what it makes now, but if you were wondering, like, is that enough, I'd say that it's more than enough if you just want to have like a fun time. Like, say for instance, if you switch shift down to the second gear and you start pulling, it has enough power to get you going. I think that's the best way to explain it. It's more than enough for you to have a decent time. But that's it. It's only enough to just get you moving. You're not going to be burning tires with this car at all. You'd be lucky to even spin out in this, because it's so underpowered. But the 2JZ GE motor has a lot of turbo kits now. So if you want a little bit more power, like 400-500 horsepower, this can do it quite easily. You put a turbo kit on, you can do all the necessary supporting mods. And with the stock bottom, and you don't even have to open the engine, and this will make 400-500 horsepower all day. The only problem you're going to have is not going to be the actual engine. It's going to be the transmission. This transmission's extremely weak. By that, I mean stupid weak. If you put anything over 300 horsepower, this is going to fall apart. The transmission, I mean. So, if you're going to go that route, I suggest, and obviously you're gonna have to do your own research, but I suggest that, you know, you put in one of the T56s, or obviously the twin turbo transmissions work great, but they're so expensive. I'd say put one of the old R156 transmissions in. They're from the Turbo Mark III Supras. They're okay. They can hold a lot of power. So if you go that route, you'll be all right. And in terms of the actual interior, it's straight out of a plane. Like, it's straight out of a fighter jet. That's the only way I can explain it. It just looks so futuristic. And I think that's the distinguishing part about this car. It looks like nothing else from the interior. It literally looks like nothing else. Like, you can try to kind of, you know, find similarities, but you won't. You won't be able to find any similarities because it's so unique. Overall, during my time of owning this, I've noticed one major thing that a lot of people fail to explain on these, you know, YouTube videos and all of that. It's the livability of the car. When I say livability, what I'm trying to say, I don't think that's even a real word. What I'm trying to say is that it's not the most comfortable car in the world. I need to kind of make that a point. It's really not the most comfortable car in the world. The rear seats are so cramped, like you can barely fit a baby at the back. And the trunk space is okay, but it's, you know, you really can't do much with it. And everything it's not a comfortable car. What I'm trying to say is that if you're thinking about daily driving one of these, I suggest you look into something else, or just, you know, buy it as a secondary car. I don't recommend you buy this as a, you know, a primary car, because you really can't get much done with this. If you're going out with friends, for instance, good luck fitting more than two people in this car. It's just not gonna work. It's just not. Overall though, I'm gonna give this car a solid 7 out of 10. I know this review hasn't really been a review, it's been more of a discussion, but you know what? It's a great car for the money. If you can afford it, get it. If you have any if you think that this is gonna be like a tire burning smoke machine, it's not. Get that out of your head, because you know that's not gonna fly. It's a great car for what it is. If you can accept that, you'll have a great time. So that being said, thanks for watching, and yeah, like, subscribe, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you guys want to see more videos, if you guys want to see any particular videos, comment, you know, let me know what you guys want to see, and I'll see what I can get done. Until next time, see you guys next time.